Greetings, this is another video overview by the flashlight reviewer selfbult. Before I get started, just my usual reminder, please make sure you have annotations turned on your YouTube player. I frequently update my reviews with additional information that you will miss if you don't have the text dialog boxes turned on. Thanks. So what I'm looking at today is a final pre-release sample of the new Thrunite Lynx. Now, you can probably tell from looking at this light, it's an update to the old Scorpion model. In fact, this engineering sample still has the Scorpion name on it with the serial number. It's very similar looking to the old Thrunite Scorpion, but what's changed is the interface and the switch design in the rear. The other thing has changed here too is the clip. In fact, if I show you, on the right here is the original Scorpion. Actually, this is the Scorpion version 2. There were a couple of Scorpion models. I've reviewed both the original one and the version 2 shown here on the right. The main difference you can see there, the clip has changed. Looks to be like a titanium-coated clip now, whereas a basic aluminum clip before. Labels are basically the same. There's a serial number now there at the bottom for the Scorpion. This is likely to change with a Lynx label, I would suspect, but I don't have details of what the final labeling will look like. The tail cap, though, is where things have changed the most, and you probably can't see it too well here. One difference is that there's a wider grip ring here on the left, but the other difference, which you can't really tell on the camera, is the tail cap is all metal now. Before, it was a plastic tail cap. There's some bits of metal. The anodized bits were metal, but the rest was plastic. Here, you have an all-metal tail cap now. This significantly adds to the weight and feel of the light, but also makes it feel more durable. Now, I understand the former tail cap was quite durable as well, but I know some people had some issues with it, so probably why they switched to the new all-metal design. In fact, I'll open it up here just to sort of show you the insides. The light looks very similar to before. You can see the tail cap. In fact, let me just take out the old Thrunite so you can see the difference. So, again, on the left is a new tail cap, on the right is the old one. They look very similar, but one thing I can tell you just from handling them, the weight is considerably different. It's more than twice as heavy, the one here on the left. Part of that, I'm sure, is the extra metal, but I suspect they've added a more additional sort of heat sink component to the base of the light. It's a lot more substantial, probably a good 40 or 50 grams. I haven't weighed it yet, but it's a very noticeable weight difference. The lights themselves look very similar. Here, if you look at the tail caps, you can see there's not really a big difference. The light, I've got similar batteries in both, so it's seated a little bit differently towards the head. So that's one sort of difference in the old model. You can't really see that in there, but there's a very pronounced spring. You don't have a spring on the new one, but you do have enough of a raised contact area that you're able to use button top and flat top cells. You'll see there's a little notch here at the top. It lines up with a notch in there on the tail cap. Hard to see here in the light. One of the nice things about these newer designs is you don't have to worry about lining that up. You can just turn it on and start screwing, and it automatically aligns with the notch to make proper contact. And I'll just get here the old model put back together as well. So you might wonder, what's the main difference here? So given the lights look so similar and the tail caps look similar, even though the extra weight on the Lynx, what's different? Well, the interface has changed considerably. One of the challenges with the original Scorpion from version 1 to version 2 was the mode sequence. Now, both lights have a tail cap switch that has four positions. So you can turn the ring to one of four positions, and there are very clear detents at each of those. In fact, you can probably hear that on the camera. So there's very clear detents at each level. The problem is it's not really intuitive what each of those levels will be. Now, they went through some iterations on the old Scorpion. So if we put this one on, say the lowest level here, at the all way to the left, you had constant on max. If you put it on one level over, you had a firefly mode. If you put it on one level over that, you had a momentary strobe mode. And one level over from that, you had, you can see, a momentary max. And these were at least customizable, so you could change the constant output to another level by pressing and holding the switch, and the light would dim, you could see, so you could customize the level. But that was it. You had two modes that were locked on, and only one of which you could customize, and two modes that were momentary on, which you also can customize. And this is not very intuitive. Whichever way you organize the ring, that's going to leave people kind of wondering what's going on. So what's new about the Lynx? What I like here is that the switch has been changed so that all four modes are fully programmable. That also means, however, that they all function as a reverse clicky style. That, in other words, there's no momentary modes possible now. I programmed the lights for a couple of modes so you can see what that looks like. Again, so as before, you have to press and release the switch to turn on. So here is a momentary, this is the lowest mode of the firefly. Click again to turn off. Turn the ring to the next position. This is a max mode, and as you can probably tell, that's a lot brighter than the max mode on the previous Scorpion. Next mode over, I've done a slow strobe, and the next mode over from there, I've done a high strobe. Now, these can all be customized. A couple of points about this interface, though. If you turn the light on in one mode, turning the ring doesn't do anything until you press the switch again. So something to keep in mind. It's a slightly, you know, different interface from other lights. It's not a typical clicky switch. It's an electronic switch that responds to presses. So if you want to switch modes, you've got to click it again to get it to come on. But this way, it's kind of nice because you can now program the four positions to whatever makes the most intuitive sense to you and how you handle the light and where you want the ring to be. The interface is, put that back into the Firefly, the interface to set the modes is similar to last time. With the light off, press and hold the switch. It'll come on and you can see it ramp up in brightness. Release the switch to select the mode that you want. If you turn the light off and back on, it always remembers the level that you set. If you want to change the mode again, from off, press and hold the switch, and you can see it has memory of which way you ramped before, because now it ramps in the opposite direction. And there I've just selected Firefly again. So to show you the full mode sequence, if I press and hold, we'll let it ramp up to max. You'll see it flashes twice at max. Then you get the slow strobe and the fast strobe, and then back to Firefly. And at any point, stop it, and your level is memorized. So that's how you set each of the levels in sequence. If you don't want to have, you know, really high levels, you can change them to something else. And again, you know, remembering that it'll, you know, ramp the opposite to whichever way it was before. And, you know, you can, so this way you can kind of have it all set to whatever kind of customized type levels that you like. I actually find this quite intuitive now. You can actually program it fully. You lose the momentary modes, however. So that's the one change from the earlier Thrunite Scorpions. Personally, I think that's kind of an acceptable trade-off because it now removes the confusion about what kind of mode you're going to get. You can program this kind of rotary ring to be four levels, whatever levels you like, and you can adjust it on the fly. So, you know, you could set it to Firefly, low, medium, and high, you know, of your own personal choosing. One thing I guess I should bring up again is let's just bring it back and we'll just crank this up to the max level so I can show you the beam pattern. And if we turn on, there we go. So kind of compare them side by side. A little bit hard to see here in the lighting in my office, but the new Scorpion is brighter than the old one. You can see that just a bit in the hot spot maybe. But the brightness is higher overall, and you'll get a better feel for that in the full numbers in my review. Obviously, the beam pattern looks very similar. It's using the same head reflector as before. The main difference now, and I should have mentioned this earlier, the Lynx is now using an XM-L2 emitter, whereas the old Scorpion was using a regular XML emitter. So you now have an XM-L2. You can see it's the same sort of smooth reflector. The same attachments from the previous Thrunite Scorpions still work. So you can get the optional throw head, which just screws on here as a replacement. And you can see the emitter well centered with a centering ring. So you can put on the head to give you a little bit more throw, which you can see gives you, hard to tell again here, but it gives you a more focused hotspot. And again, you'll see full numbers for that in my full review. I understand there's also a range of filters that are available for the light too. One thing about voltage range, so right now I'm running this on an 18650. Thrunite officially supports 18650 and 2x CR123A camera battery. It doesn't support 2x RCR, and I note the voltage range only goes up to 6 volts. So again, that would imply you shouldn't be using more than CR123As in it. So RCRs are out. I don't have any idea about what final packaging will look like. It'll probably be very similar to the previous Scorpions. Really, what you're getting here is an updated tail cap with, I think, a more solid design and a revised interface that gives you kind of greater control over mode levels, which is probably something I think most people would like to see. Anyway, hopefully that gives you a bit of an overview. To see how it performs compared to the other lights, please see my full review at Candle Power Forums. You'll find me in the reviews form under the username selfbult or off my personal review site, flashlightreviews.ca. Thanks for your time, and I hope you found that useful.